everyone, welcome back to homeschool and I am with one more interesting and wonderful chapter of class 10, that is light, reflection and refraction. See guys, we have covered all chemistry related chapters and all bio related chapters and two chapters have been covered in physics so far, that is electricity and the magnetic effect of electric current. So if you want to have a detailed understanding about these completed chapters, links are provided in the description. You can go and refer and get a complete clarity on all the concepts. We are here to make the concepts much easier and study the concepts in a detailed way in our channel. So please do subscribe our channel to learn the concepts in an easier way, in a detailed way. See, coming back to the chapter, light, reflection and refraction. Actually, it's a very simple chapter, nothing to worry about. Only thing is, you should have awareness about certain basics here. Clear? And you know, the whole chapter is about the spherical mirrors. Okay, reflection in a spherical mirror. And also, you will study about refraction by spherical lenses. So, the chapter is about reflection and refraction of spherical things, spherical mirrors and spherical lenses. Right? Fine. And today's video, I am going to cover the necessary basics, okay, to understand the whole concepts of this particular chapter. See, these basics include certain terms, right, whose meaning is very, very important to understand. And after learning a few terms, we will go for discussing about the reflection, okay, in today's video itself. So, we will see the reflection, its definition, and reflection has two important laws. Actually, all these things you have been studying right from class 7, isn't it? See, it's a kind of refreshing the entire things, right? And we also discuss about the reflection in a plane mirror. So, how does an image appears in a plane mirror? See, it's not been mentioned in your textbook, but it is very much essential to understand how image is formed in a plane mirror so that you get an idea how images can be formed, right? So let us start the chapter with certain basic terms. See, we all know the light. So if I ask you what is light, what is your answer? See, light is a form of energy. Very simple, right? Light is a form of energy. Light is everywhere. Right? Say, in a daytime, we can see all things with our naked eyes. But in night time, we cannot see anything. That's a common thing everybody knows. So my question is, how our eyes can see each and everything whenever a light is there? Whenever a sunlight is there? Whenever a light is on in a room? You know, what happens? You can see everything. How is it possible? Why you cannot see anything when there is no light, when it is very much dark, right? So all these things we will discuss, don't worry. See, we all got to know light is a form of energy, right? And where does the light come from? Who is giving us a light? Is it a magic that light is coming on its own? No, right? See, it is coming from some object, guys. Light will always come from some object, and that particular object we will call it as a source. Okay, so here the very first term I am going to discuss is about a source. So what is a source here? I am talking about light source. Okay, so source is an object from which light comes. From which light comes. Can you give an example? Right? And again, before we go to the examples, there are two types of sources. Okay. So, there are two types of sources actually. What are they? First one is luminous. Luminous sources. Okay. And the second variety is non-luminous. Non-luminous. So, what do you mean by a luminous source? This is very important. What do you mean by a luminous source? You know, this particular luminous sources has light of its own. It has light of its own. Okay. Examples are sun. Yes or no? Sun has a light on its own. You know, sun gives the light actually. So, such an object we will call it as luminous sources. Sun, then electric bulb. Say in the night time, if you want to see the things, you will on a light. It can be an electric bulb or it can be a tube light or torch bulb, anything for that matter. It can be a lamp or whatever. So, all these have lights of its own. Okay, so these things, actually these objects are giving light for us. That's the reason we can able to see all the things. So, such an object which has light on its own and they give light to others, okay, to visualize the things, are called luminous sources. So, what are the examples? Sun, electric bulb, lamp. You know, all these things are luminous sources. Clear? And now, what do you mean by the non-luminous source do not have light on its own? Do not have light on its own. Clear? Say for example, chair, table. Right, we human beings, you know, all of us do not have our own light. See, light cannot come from us. We do not have light of our own, isn't it? So, only thing is, we actually scatter the light coming from luminous sources. Okay, from luminous sources, light enters, light falls on us. And we scatter that light. We distribute that light. That's it. Okay, so such an object, we will call it as non-luminous sources. Clear? So everybody understood about a source, right? So source is an object from which actually light comes. Okay, source is an object that has a light is called luminous source and that do not has light on its own is called non-luminous source. Clear? Fine. And the second point or the second term is about a medium. So, what do you mean by a medium? Look at here. Medium is a substance, guys. Okay. Through which light propagates. Through which light propagates. Clear? Propagates in the sense what? Light travels. Clear? So that is called medium. And again, there are three types of mediums we have. Okay, the first one is transparent medium. Transparent medium. Second one, translucent medium. Translucent medium. And the third one is opaque medium. Okay, so what's a medium? Say if a light have to travel, you know, it needs a medium. It needs certain substance. So, only through a substance, it can travel. Right? So, such a substance through which light propagates or travels is called a medium. Again, there are three types here. Transparent medium. So, what do you mean by a transparent medium here? Transparent medium is a medium through which light propagates easily. Okay? Through this kind of a medium, light propagates easily. It can travel very easily. Example is air, glass, etc. See, light from a sun, where it is coming? It is coming to the atmosphere. It is traveling in atmosphere. Atmosphere has a lot of air, right? So, air is a medium here. So, in air, light can pass very easily from one area to another area. Clear? So, such a medium in which, through which light passes very easily is called transparent medium. Okay? So, examples are air, glass. Even through a glass, you know, light rays can pass very easily. Right? Okay. The next type of a medium is translucent medium. Say, translucent medium through which light travels partially. Light propagates partially. Okay. So, in this medium, light propagates partially. Not completely. Okay. Partially. Say, for example, paper. If you hold a torch in front of a paper, what happens? Do you observe 100% light rays being passed out of the paper? No, right? Light can pass, no doubt, but very little of light is getting passed through a paper, right? Say, this is what we mean by light propagating partially. So, such a medium we call it as translucent medium. Okay. And opaque medium, light do not propagate in this particular medium. Say for example, hood, metals. If you take a hood, a big piece of a hood, hold the torch, okay, will the light travel through the hood and will the light rays come out of the hood? Never, right? So hood is actually a opaque medium here. Opaque medium is a medium through which light rays do not propagate. Clear? So this is all about a medium. And now I kept on using something called rays, light rays, right? So what do you mean by that ray? What do you mean by a ray here? Ray is a straight line path. Okay, it is nothing but a straight line path in which light travels. Clear? Light always travels in a straight line path. So, that particular path of light, we will call it as ray. Okay? Many rays, a beam of rays actually passes in a medium. Clear everybody? See, ray is always indicated like this. This means that light is traveling in this direction. Okay? So it is always indicated with this arrow mark. Say if I put an arrow mark like this, what does this mean? Light is traveling in this direction. Okay? Say if I put an arrow mark like this, the light is traveling like this. Right? So the ray shows the direction of light. Okay, in which it is propagating. Clear everybody? And now here, imagine we are not talking about a single light rays. We speak about, a beam of light rays actually. Right? See, if all the light rays are coming and meeting at a particular point. Okay, see here what happened? All the light rays are coming and they are meeting at this particular point. Okay, and this phenomenon is what we call it as converging. Okay, converging. And I call it as convergent rays. Convergent rays. Say, if all the light rays are coming and meeting at certain point, then, such rays, such a beam, we call it as convergent ray. Okay, or the phenomenon, this process of meeting all the light rays at one point is called converging. It's a phenomenon of converging. Okay. And if the opposite thing happens, what do you mean by the opposite thing? Say, if light rays are going away from one particular point, then this phenomenon is called diverging. Diverging. And this is called divergent rays. Okay. And if light rays are going like this, they are not meeting, they are parallel, right? So this phenomenon is called parallel. Say they are going straight and the rays are parallel to each other. Okay. They are not meeting anywhere and they are not moving away from any point. Just they are going in straight, parallel to each other. So this condition is called parallel. Whereas if the light rays are going away from one point, is called diverging rays. Okay. If the light rays are coming and meeting at a certain point, then this is called converging phenomenon. See, these meanings are very important to understand, where you will come across these words being used in a chapter. Okay. So you must understand what do you mean by converging, convergent rays, divergent rays, and parallel rays. parallel in the sense going straight and parallel to each other. They are not meeting anywhere. Okay, but convergent in the sense they are meeting, all the rays are meeting at one point. Diverging in the sense from a point they are going away. They are going away. That is divergent. Clear? So these terms are very, very important to understand. Right? And now let us talk about the so-called reflection. So people, how do you define reflection? And you know, how do we see many things with the help of a light? It is due to a reflection. Clear? See, I will tell you how we can see, how we can able to see the many things when there is a light. Clear? Before that, let us try to understand the definition of a reflection. See, reflection is very simple, guys. It is a phenomenon of bouncing back of light. Okay, phenomenon, try to understand the definition. Even for examination point of view, this is important only. Okay, phenomenon of bouncing back of light in a same medium. In a same medium, when does a light bounces back in a same medium? When it strikes at a particular surface, when it strikes on a surface is called reflection. Imagine if I have a ball here, I hit the ball onto a board. What happens? Ball will come back. That's what a reflection, guys. Okay, so I'm hitting a ball and the ball is coming back. In the same way, when a light ray hit on a particular surface, it comes back. It comes back. The same light ray comes back. It reflects. That's what we call it as a reflection. Okay? So, phenomenon of bouncing back. Phenomenon of bouncing back of a light when a light hits on a surface. Clear? So, this is what we mean by a reflection. And you know, there are two important laws of reflection. They are very, very important to understand actually. Imagine this is our surface where I am striking light rays on this surface. Okay, actually this indicates a mirror, guys. I am taking a plane mirror. Okay, and what is this dash dash lines mean? It means that this side is polished. Okay, always mirrors are made up of glass where one side is polished with silver. Okay, so this lines indicates that this side of a mirror is polished and this side is a flat surface where light falls and it gets reflected. Okay, so I am taking this glass surface here where one side is polished. Yeah. And this is some imaginary line perpendicular to the surface I am drawing, and this is called normal. Always this imaginary line is very much essential. Okay, that imaginary line, which we call it as normal, it has to be drawn perpendicular to the surface where light rays are falling. Remember this. And now you see here, this is a ray that is falling on this particular surface at this point. Okay, and the ray that is striking at a particular point, the ray that is coming and striking on a surface of an object is called incident ray. Which is this ray called? Incident ray. And that incident ray do not go into the object, or that particular light ray is not absorbed by the object. It is completely reflected back. It is completely reflected back, and such a ray is called as reflected ray. This is called reflected ray. So light ray which is coming and hitting a surface and again it's going back. The ray which is hitting initially is called incident ray, and the ray that is reflected is called reflected ray. Okay, and incident ray is making an angle with a normal, right? See, here is an angle that you can make out. So this is called angle of incidence. And reflected ray, the ray that is reflected is also making an angle with respect to normal. And this angle is called as reflected angle of reflection. Okay. And the very first law says that angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Okay, it's very easy to understand, right? See, if the angle the incident ray is making with a normal is 30 degree, then the angle of reflection is also 30 degree. So, what I can easily say is angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. This is the first law of reflection. And the second law is also very simple, guys. Incident ray, listen carefully. Incident ray, normal, that is the imaginary line that we have drawn perpendicular to the surface of an object. That is what normal and reflected ray, all lie in a same plane. I mean, all are there in a same side. Okay, incident ray, normal and reflected ray, all are there in a same side. They are placed in a same plane. Okay, all the three lines I am drawing on a board, on a plane of a board, isn't it? That's what we mean by all the three are there on a same side. So we say incident ray, normal and reflected ray all lie in a same plane. Clear? So these are the two important laws of reflection. So as I told you, each and everything that we can see whenever light is there is all because of reflection, right? Now I will explain what actually happens here. Say for example, in front of me, I have some apple. Okay, say this particular apple I can see whenever light is there. If the room is dark, you know, I can't see the apple, right? Say, what actually happening is the light rays are actually falling on apple, right? The light ray is falling on an apple and the ray is not going into the apple, right? And this is what we call incident ray, which is falling on an apple, and this ray is completely reflecting back. Okay, and if that reflected ray reaches my eye, okay, if that reflected ray reaches my eye, then I can see this apple. Okay, so this is how we can see all the things due to the reflection. See, I can see the board is because what's happening here is the light rays are falling on a board, the same rays are reflecting. Okay, those reflected rays are reaching my eyes. Okay, when I'm standing in a correct position, in a correct direction, the reflected rays are reaching my eyes. Okay, that's the reason I can see the board. In case if I go out of this room, can I able to see the board? No, right? Because the reflected rays are not reaching my eyes. If I go out of this room, I can't see the reflected rays cannot reach my eyes. Only when I stand here in this particular room, in this particular angle, you know, the reflected, the light rays fall on a board and those rays are reflecting. Those reflecting rays can reach my eyes, right? They are reaching my eyes. So my eye can visualize, I can see this particular board. So each and everything that you see with your eyes is because of this particular reflection, guys. Okay, see, that's the reason reflection is a very, very important phenomenon to understand carefully, right? And now we will talk about the mirrors. Especially this particular video includes everything about the plane mirrors. Yeah, so guys, what do you mean by a mirror? See, mirror is made up of a glass, guys. All mirrors are made up of a glass where one side is polished. This is very important. Where one side is polished, usually polished with silver, guys. Because, you know, the silver can reflect 98% of the light rays back. That's the reason we always polish the mirrors with silver. Okay, so imagine this is a glass. Okay, it has two sides. One is this side, the other one is this side. See, I completely polish one side with a silver. This side, this particular side, I polished with the silver. Okay, then what happens is, this is a side available for a light rays to fall. So what happens is, light rays fall on a mirror and they automatically, all the rays can get reflected back. Okay, they will not pass through the mirror. See, mirror is made up of a glass. Actually, through a glass, the light rays can propagate easily. They can travel easily. But though it is a glass, the light rays are not traveling through it. They are not coming back. Okay, all the light rays which are falling on this surface is getting reflected back. It's because of the polish that is there on the other side. Backside we have silver polishing, right? So that silver reflects all the rays back. It will not absorb any of the light rays. It will not allow, the polish will not allow any of the light rays. See, the silver polish will say, all the light rays just go away from me. Okay, so the silver polish will not allow any of the rays to travel through the mirror, right? All the light rays which are incident on it has to get reflected back. Okay, so multiple reflections are seen with the help of a mirror. Clear, everybody? So this is what we mean by a mirror. So mirror is completely made up of a glass where one side is polished with silver coating. Yeah, the other side is free, where light rays when fall, all the rays can get deflected. And there are actually two types of mirrors. First one is a plain mirror. Okay, second one is spherical mirrors. So actually our chapter is all about the spherical mirrors. So a very basic idea I will give in today's video about the spherical mirrors. So more things we study about the plane mirrors. So what do you mean by a plane mirror? Plane mirror looks flat. Okay, its surface is flat. I mean reflecting surface is flat. I can say in plane mirror, reflecting surface is flat. Okay, so such a mirror is called as plane mirror. Whereas the spherical mirror, reflecting surfaces are curved. Here, reflecting surfaces, the surface on which the light rays fall and they get reflected back, no? So that is what we mean by reflecting surface. So reflecting surface is curved here. It is not flat. See, the plane mirror, the best example is the mirror that is there in your houses. The mirrors that we use to get ready, right? So the surface of a mirror is very much flat. Okay, and you know, that is what your reflecting surface. But whereas the spherical mirrors, the reflecting surfaces are not flat. They are curved. That's the reason we call them as spherical mirrors. Okay, say for example, this is a glass sphere. Okay, this is a sphere which is made up of a glass. I have taken a glass ball. Okay, take it as glass ball. If I cut this glass ball here, what do I get? I get a shape something like this. I get a shape something like this. See, I have cut a glass ball something like this. Okay, see? This is how I get. And imagine this side I have polished with silver. This side I have polished with silver. Then which is a reflecting surface? This is a reflecting surface. And see the reflecting surface, is it flat? No, it is curved. It is curved. Right? Then this is an example for spherical mirror. Actually, there are two types of spherical mirrors. One is concave mirror and the other one is convex mirror. Okay? See, this particular mirror is actually concave mirror. Concave mirror. That means the reflecting surface is facing inwards. The reflecting surface is facing inwards. It's like a cave form, right? And imagine the same piece. I will polish this particular side. I am polishing the inner side. Now, which is the reflecting surface? This is our reflecting surface, right? See, reflecting surface is not flat. It is bulged. It is curved. That's why it is also a spherical mirror. And this is actually a convex mirror. Okay? See, in case of concave mirror, the reflecting surface is facing inwards. Okay? Cave shaped. In case of convex mirror, the reflecting surface is facing outwards. You know, this is what convex. Anyway, about concave and convex mirror, we study in detail in the next video. Now, let us concentrate only about a plane mirror. So, plane mirror is a flat mirror. Okay, it's a very flat mirror that is there in our houses that we use every day to get ready for hours together, right? So, let us see how an image forms in a plane mirror. See guys, if this is a mirror, so in front of a mirror, if a guy is standing, what happens? He or she's image is appeared on a mirror, okay, exactly as it is. See, there is no change in the size, there is no change in the shape. However you are in front of a mirror, as it is appeared in a mirror. Okay, and have you observed one thing? You feel that your image is behind the mirror. Okay, you can go and check it once. If you stand in a mirror, you feel that your image is exactly behind the mirror. But exactly it is not. Nothing is there behind the mirror. But image appears like that. Okay, image appears as though you are there. The image is there behind the mirror. Right? How is it possible? That's what we are going to discuss now. Okay, so actually the images formed in a plane mirror are virtual. They are virtual and erect. They are virtual and erect. Remember, virtual in the sense not real. Not real. It's not a real you. Whatever you are seeing behind the mirror, it appears as though the reflection, your reflection is there behind the mirror, right? But it's not real you. It's not the real image. Okay? So something which is not real is called virtual. And the image is erect. Erect in the sense upright. See, your head is up. It's not that your head is appearing down in the mirror. Right? Your head is up only, even in the mirror. So that's what image is erect, we say. Erect in the sense upright. However you are, the same way you look in a mirror also. That's what we mean by erect. Okay, fine. And let us see how the images, virtual images, are formed in a plane mirror. Okay, observe carefully guys. It's a very interesting phenomena. This is our plane mirror. Okay. So, this lines, I told you, it's nothing but this side is polished. Okay, back side of the mirror and this is front side of the mirror. Right? And imagine this is our object. Okay, so this is our object. And how this object's image is formed in a mirror, like how it looks as though it is there behind the mirror. That's what we are going to discuss. See, before going to this, you know how we can see ourselves in a mirror? What actually happens is the light rays, you know, in a room, the tube light would be there, or it may be a light from a sun or whatever it is. Okay. Light rays initially fall on us. Okay. They fall and they get reflected onto a mirror. Okay. Mirror, you know, this is the incident ray that is falling on a mirror, and this incident ray again gets reflected, and this reflected ray actually reaches our eye. Okay, at that point of time we can see ourselves in a mirror, guys. So this is what we call multiple reflection. See, one reflection is this: from light the rays are falling on us, from us it is reflecting back to the mirror, it is falling onto a mirror. And from mirror, whatever the rays are falling, all are reflecting back. And these reflected rays are reaching our eyes. That's the reason we can visualize ourselves inside a mirror. Okay, fine. Now let us see how this virtual image is formed and how the image looks as though it is there behind the mirror. Okay, so now see guys, this is an object and this is a mirror. So actually some incident ray is falling onto a mirror from the object. Yes or no? The rays would move from object to mirror. That's what we call incident ray, and they will again reflect back. Yes or no? So this is the incident ray that is coming from the object and it is falling onto a mirror at this point. And this ray has to get reflected back. And if you want to know in which direction, like in which angle it is getting reflected, we need to draw a normal. Okay, we should follow the laws of reflection here. So to know the angle of incidence and to know the angle of reflection, you know, a normal has to be there compulsorily. So how will you draw a normal here? So normal is any line that is perpendicular to the plane of this mirror, right? So imagine this is our normal. Okay, so this is a normal for this particular incident ray. And now the same ray, how does it get reflected? And this is the angle of incident. The same angle it makes here also, this side, that is angle of reflection. Okay, so this is our reflected ray. This is our reflected ray. Okay, and we take at least two rays to show the formation of image. Yes or no? See, only one ray is not helpful to show the image. You have to take many rays. At least two rays I am taking here. Okay, so this is one ray. This is one ray, a ray fallen here at this point and it reflected back. Okay, and I will take another ray here. See, I am taking another ray. Okay, so this is another incident ray and again it should reflect, right? So if it has to reflect, you know what happens? A normal, this is the normal, imagine this is the normal for this particular incident ray and it is reflecting back. Okay, say this is my first reflected ray, this is my second reflected ray. So what is happening here? The reflected rays are diverging here. Okay, they are not meeting at one point, they are going back. Actually, where do they meet? See, image is formed at a place where the reflected rays meet. Keep this point always in your mind. Okay, image is formed at a point where reflected rays meet. Reflected rays meet. And do you observe the meeting of reflected ray? Say this is the first reflected ray, this is the second reflected ray. First reflected ray is going in that direction, second one is going in this direction. So where are they meeting here? See, if you can extrapolate them, extrapolate in the sense if you can, draw them backside. Okay, say if this ray is moving here, okay, in a backside, this is my imagination. If they have to meet, they should meet backside of the mirror only. Okay, front side, it's like they are going in two different directions. Say if I extend this line here and if I extend this line here, you know, they are meeting at this point, right? So definitely at this point, you will observe the image of this particular object. So this arrow mark is my object. So this object you will observe here. Where are you observing? You are observing behind the mirror. Okay. So this particular image, we will call it as virtual. It is not actually a real image. Just a virtual image. And it is erect also. Erect. See, it is erect, upright. Okay. And you observe one thing. It appears, the image appears backside of the mirror. Okay, the reflected rays are actually meeting backside of the mirror. And you know, the reflected ray, originally speaking, they cannot go backside of the mirror. Backside of the mirror, nothing is there. Silver polished, nothing is there. There are no light rays. This is just our imagination. This is how we are predicting. Actually, whenever we see in front of a mirror, our image seems like it is their backside, no? For that, this is the reason. Okay, if you extend your reflected rays, it is meeting at this point. Image is always formed wherever the reflected rays are meeting actually. So, these reflected rays meet backside. That's why the image appears that it is their backside of the mirror. Okay, so such an image which is forming backside of the mirror is called virtual image. Okay, say for example, virtual image definition can also be given like this. Imagine if I put a screen between you and a mirror. Okay, can you see your image? You can't see your image, right? Say whenever a screen is placed between an object and a mirror, image cannot be seen. Such an image is called as virtual image. Okay, if it is a real image, image can be seen even on the screen also. Your image can be seen on a screen also. That you will observe in concave mirrors. Okay, but this is a plane mirror. Don't worry about real images. I'll explain in the next video. Okay, just try to understand, virtual images are formed always backside of the mirror. Okay, this point is important. Virtual images are formed backside of the mirror. Backside of mirror, because the reflected rays are meeting backside, not in the front. Clear? So this is how we can explain the image formation in case of plane mirrors. Say, in the same way, we have to study image formation in case of concave and convex. For that also, we need so many basics to understand that we will discuss in my next class. See guys, that's all about the characteristics of plane mirror. Say, if characteristics of plane mirrors are asked, two points are very, very important to mention. Here always the images are virtual and erect. Okay, and the image is formed backside the mirror. Clear everyone? Fine. So with this, I will stop the today's session. So in my next class, we will start discussing about the spherical mirrors. And there are so many important terms whose meaning is very, very important to understand the further concept. Okay, so let us discuss everything about spherical mirrors in the next video. Till then, keep revising the concept. Do subscribe our channel to learn the concepts in the easiest way and in a detailed way. And you can post your questions in the comment box. And you can also tell about your opinion about the concept or about the class. Okay, so your comments mean a lot. So do comment. Thank you so much.